What's going on, folks? This is Mr. Apathy, Devlan James, come to you with another video. Those of you familiar with the YouTube channel Terrence Popp and Redunculus.com, which is a damn good channel, by the way, know that for each video he does, depending on the topic and what mood he's in, he's either good Popp if he wears his black shirt or bad Popp if he wears the red one. Click on the link to watch one of his videos. Well, in this video, I'm going to follow a similar format, only I'm not wearing any different colored shirts. Now, I'm telling you straight out, I'm going to be a dick in this video. So say hello to the bad guy, because I'm addressing a certain segment of single mothers in this video. I know this is going to piss many of them off, but guess what? I don't give a shit. Now, when I say single mothers, I'm not talking about women who are widows and single moms due to the death of a spouse, or women who are single moms because they left a physically abusive relationship. Now, I'm not talking about any women in those two scenarios. Instead, I'm talking to women who love them, they're thugs and they're bad boys. I'm talking to the type of women that won't even talk to a man unless he's over 6 feet tall. They themselves could be like 5'1 and petite. But the man they talk to gotta be 6 foot or taller, or she ain't interested. Don't even waste your time. Yeah, I'm addressing these types of women. So, you're hooked up with your over 6 foot tall bad boy and let him run up in you raw. Now you have a kid by him, and he's nowhere around. See, somehow you finally figured out, after the child was born, of course, that the father wasn't shit to begin with. So he's no longer in the picture, and you have to raise his seed on your own. Or better way of phrasing it, you have to raise his son without a good male role model in your household, to both keep him in check and be an example of what to aspire to and become the man. These are the types of single mothers I'm targeting in this video. You know what most of you single mothers are raising? Little baby Frankensteins. That's right. Little monsters that will most likely end up terrorizing the communities they reside in when they get older. And the villagers? Well, the villagers will want to run both you and that little monster out of town with pitchforks and torches. And rightfully so. Think I'm talking out of my ass, ladies? Well, let's look at the statistics. When I last checked, 70% of all boys coming from single-parent homes end up in prison. So, you're a baby Frankenstein will most likely end up being some kind of criminal. Either a murderer, a rapist, a thief, or a drug dealer. Basically, a menace to society. And that's going to happen under your watch, because the older and bigger he gets, the less and less you'll be able to control him. You see, this is where these women fuck themselves up. Like Vince Rashad mentioned in one of his videos, these women lack the ability to have linear thought. They can't connect cause and effect. Lady, if you are 5'1 and 110 pounds, and you choose to get knocked up by a 6'4, 260 pound thug or bad boy, there is this thing called genetics, where there is now a high probability that your little Frankenstein will inherit your baby daddy genes and his 6'4, 260 pound frame. And he will throw you around like a Raggedy Ann doll when he gets older. Like in most of my videos, I have a true life example. About 4 years ago, back in 2010, I briefly, and I mean briefly, dated such a woman. a divorced single mother with a baby Frankenstein. We'll call her son Little Andre. And the mother, well, honestly, she isn't worth the effort of coming up with a fictitious name for her. She might as well be a fly on a dog's ass. That's how irrelevant this woman is to me. I know some of you are like, man, what a harsh dick thing to say. Yeah, well, I told you I was going to be a dick in this video. Anyway, there really isn't much I can say about a narcissistic, mean-spirited bitch. Some of you might be wondering, where did you find such a quality single mother, Devlan? Which I will answer. Oh, you didn't know? Why, at meetplentyofsorryasssinglemoms.com, of course. Oh, I mean plentyoffish.com. So, the first time I met Little Andre was the first time I met his mother, an ice cream stand in town. He was only 4 at the time, and I remember this kid was all over the place, and she couldn't control him. You would think the kid did a line of coke before he came out of the house. Talk about wired. I was tired from just watching him bouncing all over the place. Now let's flash forward to an incident that I know that one little twat that always thumbs down my videos will appreciate. Little 4-year-old Andre punched me in the eye. Or came close to it. Yep. Now again, this was 4 years ago. I had gone to a carnival with Andre and his mother the evening before. And the next morning, little Andre came into the room with his storybooks and climbed into bed with me and his mother. Now, I was laying down while he and his mother were reading one of the books. My elbow happened to brush against one of his books. Next thing I know, I saw Andre's little balled-up fist coming towards my eye. I moved in time so he didn't catch my full eye, but the little bastard delivered a blow to a full-grown man, followed by what sounded like a threat. What? Guys, I think I had an out-of-body experience where the West Indian in me came out, and I was floating above the room, watching myself put my foot so far up little Andre's ass that I had to open his mouth to adjust my shoes. But, in actuality, I didn't touch him. I have a strict policy about hitting other people's kids. I just don't do it. Plus, that's a quick way to get arrested. For those of you guys who are dating single mothers, you may not be aware of this, but if you even get into an argument with that single mother, okay, she can call the cops on you and say that her child was a danger from the argument. And that alone, if she calls and says, hey, you know, was child endangerment for him arguing with me? Without question, they'll take you out of there in handcuffs. Never happened to me, thank God, but it can happen. So proceed with caution when you're dating these single mothers. So, I didn't touch her kid. But I did leave right away, though. I had to, or I would have, like, had a fucking conniption or something. I left just as his mother gave him some bullshit little timeout. Now, guys, process all that for a moment. Here you got a 4-year-old kid throwing a punch at a grown man, and then threatening that same grown man. This kid has no concept of consequences versus action. And you can see that this kid is already on the yellow brick path to becoming a potential criminal or a menace to society. And that's just one instance. There are many more. I kept in loose contact with this woman and little Andre, especially after a shaming comment this chick threw my way. I told her early on you know, I think I'm going to avoid getting married and having kids. And she said to me, oh, you're being a coward for opting out of that. There's nothing like having a child. And I remember thinking to myself, what a dumb bitch. She obviously doesn't understand the depth of what she's gotten herself into. So I kept in loose contact with them to watch the ongoing train wreck that is her life. Little background on this chick. She's what I call a part-time weekend mom. She works in the city. And during the week, the laundry stays at Grandma and Granddaddy daycare. And when the weekend comes, he's either shipped back to Mommy Dearest or to his father's, depending on who has custody for that weekend. Oh, and the father lives with the woman he used to bang on the side when he was married to the mother. What an arrangement, huh? No wonder this kid has behavioral issues to the nth degree. I think his mother went through the most drama when little Andre turned 5. First, he was kicked out of his school at 5. How does that happen? Well, apparently Andre was so disruptive and uncontrollable that they didn't want to deal with him, so they just kicked him out of the school. So she had to scramble to find him a new school. Then another day, she had to rush to her parents' house all the way from the city to contain him because he had a meltdown. In a fit of rage, he ripped down her parents' curtains and was screaming at them not to touch him. And of course, she doesn't let them discipline him. I think she started taking him to the psychiatrist after that. I don't know why this woman can't see that this kid is acting out because of the environment she's raising him in. It's not healthy. Here he is being bounced around from place to place, only seeing each parent every other weekend. The kid has no grounding, no foundation from which to grow. That's why his behavior is so erratic, because the way they have him bouncing from place to place during the week is erratic. Kids need stability and discipline, especially when they're so young. Now, it's funny how the cowardly MGTOW bachelor knows this, but she, the brave parent, doesn't. She even asked me during this time if I would be willing to spend time with little Andre on the weekends she had him, because I would make a good male role model for him. Could you imagine that? Now the cowardly MGTOW bachelor is a good male role model for her kid. I basically told her no, I don't have the time. And my time is too valuable for her, little Andre, and their bullshit. I also told her, just don't put the kid on Ritalin. Isn't that just like most of these single mothers, though? The decent men aren't good enough to impregnate them, but then they want you to help them raise another man's seed. Get the fuck out of here. Look, if I didn't help you make him, I'm not going to help you raise him. That's my policy on single mothers and their kids. The end. How many single mothers out there are living a life similar to the woman in this video and dealing with kids that have major behavioral issues, which is usually a direct result of the environment these women are raising these kids in? I don't date single moms anymore. That one was the last one. I've found that there really isn't much to them. Most of them are just whack. All they do is work and pick up their sorry ass kids from some daycare or from their parents. They have no life or personality outside of that. I don't even talk to that chick anymore, to be honest. I'm going to close this video out by saying this. The last time I saw and spoke to that woman was in December of 2013, and she was with a not-so-little Andre at the time. Now, this is where genetics and the whole Baby Frankenstein thing comes into play. Now, this woman is about 5'4 or 5'5, and Andre was 7 at the time I saw them. This kid at 7 is already up to her shoulders and growing. She is fucked. He is on his way to that 6'4, 260-pound build. Another baby Frankenstein in the making, bred to terrorize a village full of people. Anyway, guys, that's all I got for you today. Have you guys come across any single moms like the one I talked about in this video with their little baby Frankensteins? I would love to hear about it. Just comment in the comment box below. Anyway, thanks for watching. If you like this video, please feel free to share it with friends or on Facebook. And if you haven't done so already, please subscribe. More videos to come.